Now, what I finally want to do is end off talking about equilibrium. And this is just a simple pattern that we're going to use throughout all of these reactions. And all it says is this. A base will always attack an acid. So notice I'm already telling you what's going to happen. A base, negative, will attack an acid, positive, to produce conjugates. Scary word. Remember that from Gen Chem? Conjugates in the following chemical pattern. So this is the way it works. Basically, you're always going to get your stronger base and your stronger acids, okay, reacting together to make a weaker base and a weaker acid. Okay, so you always go from stronger to weaker. It just makes sense. You're never going to go from weaker to stronger. That doesn't make any sense. Okay, and then what we're going to do is everything that's on the right side of the arrow, okay, everything that's after reaction, we're going to call that a conjugate. Okay, the conjugate means that's what happened after it reacted. Okay, so basically, and then everything beforehand, we're just going to call it the regular base and the regular acid. Okay, so what that means is that my base is always going to turn into a conjugate acid, and my acid is always going to turn into a conjugate base. I know that's a little bit confusing, and a lot of people mix that up. Okay, but that's just something you have to remember. Your base is going to turn into a weaker acid, and then your acid is going to turn into a weaker base than the ones that were on the other side. Okay, and then also just that the Ke has to do with the equilibrium constant, and all that's saying is that it's always going to go to the right. Basically, Ke over 1 means that it's going to the right if your conjugates are weaker. Okay, if your conjugates are weaker, then it's going to the right. If your conjugates are stronger, then it would go to the left, because then it's going to go the other way. Okay, does that kind of make sense? Now, I know that last part was a little bit rushed, but thankfully we're going to do tons of practice with this, so by the end of today you're not going to have a problem with conjugates. Okay, so if you have any questions, let me know, but if not, let's move on to the next topic.